plant when it first started up. Was plant manager here many years ago. And then unfortunately when it came time to close the plant, also did that plant announcement. It's a team I knew very well, a team I was with for a lot of years. So when the time came and the decision was made to close the plant, it was a very emotional event for me.
When we were looking for our locations for the next facility, we had a number of them in mind, including a lot of locations overseas. The real enabler to us putting this facility in Michigan was the grant award that we received through the Recovery Act, along combined with incentives from the state of Michigan.
The Recovery Act really does give a lot of hope for those people that want to come back to the community, whether they were graduates that didn't have jobs or they moved to find a job, that they're going to be able to come back.
In 2010, our company will celebrate our 125th anniversary. In our automotive business, we supply seats and interior products. In our battery business, the odds are, if you're in North America anyways, that battery is from Johnson Controls. Your lead acid battery is primarily used to start your vehicle, light the lights, but in the future, the battery is going to be the drivetrain of your vehicle. Your internal combustion engine will potentially disappear and be replaced with a battery pack that is the power source within your vehicle. I mean, the United States has got to electrify their vehicle network in order to help reduce the amount of CO2 emissions that are globally going into the atmosphere.
We're going to need an extremely high-performing team. We're going to need to bring in the culture that we want to have.
Today, there's not one of these built in the United States. I mean, our vision with this plant is that we get to the point where we're building 15 million of these cells in this facility on an annual basis.
The project right now, what you're going to see at Meadowbrook is an empty plant because there's the four or five of us starting to come together.
Taking out the trash.
And we've been in the design phase. So that means what has to happen to the building, how is it going to be laid out.
Okay.
Where we're standing right now is where our pack assembly is going to come in. And that's the first part of our process. So actually that's coming in very soon. We're going to have equipment and materials coming into the dock doors right here. So we've got to get that ready. Just recently been writing the tech specs for the equipment.
I had a discussion with Elizabeth a minute ago and she says every day she gets a number of calls. There's just a buzz in the community right now.
So to come back now and open this plant and have some of the same people calling and very interested in coming back and excited about the opportunity is it's an emotional event for me, and it's just a huge deal for all those people in the community as well. Do you guys in your math classes yet ever have a math problem that is so long you might not get the right answer, but at least you get partial credit? You know, for those kids that are sitting there, those Cub Scouts, and they're talking about pollution and they're talking about, you know, $4 a gallon gas prices, the evolution they're going to see is very likely in the transportation industry. You know, we don't want the kids to grow up and leave the community necessarily. We want them to grow up, get a good technical base that can support the industries here, and we're going to need them. It seems like it's a long ways away for Cub Scouts, but it goes fast.